Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is lecture number 4 of chemical bonding. In the last lecture, we studied about concept of hybridization and the types of hybridization. In this video, we are going to see hybridization using s and p orbitals. As we studied in the yesterday lecture, there are two types of hybridizations are there, that is using sp orbitals, using sp and d orbitals. In this video, we are going to study the hybridization using s and p orbitals, of which we are going to study, that is here we can see the sp hybridization, that is sp hybridization, sp2 hybridization and sp3 hybridization. Yes, this one we have seen in the yesterday's lecture, that is hybridization, which are mainly of two types. Using s and p orbital is the one type, having sp2 sp3 hybridization, and the second one using sp and d orbitals, which involves dsp2 sp3d sp3d2 hybridization. So likewise sp3d3 as well. As so these are the hybridization involving sp and d orbitals. Here the shapes already we seen that s orbital is spherical shape, that is p orbital we having the dumbbell shape, and the d orbitals we having the double dumbbell shape of the different shapes. We, by using these orbitals, we can study the concept of hybridization. Now first let me start with the sp hybridization. Hybridization is already we studied in the yesterday's lecture, that is mixing, process of mixing and recasting of atomic orbitals, and they form into new equivalent hybrid orbitals having the equal and identical shape. So here, what is the sp hybridization or linear hybridization? This sp hybridization is also called as the linear hybridization. It is a very simple definition is there. Sp means only s and p orbital is there. It indicates the process of mixing of 1s and 1p orbital. See, very simple, it is a mixing of 1s and 1p orbitals to form two new equivalent hybrid orbitals of identical energy and the shape, known as sp hybridization or linear hybridization. See, very simple, we just in the hybridization, which type of hybrid orbitals going to be involved, means there is a 1s orbital is there, 1p orbital is there. Therefore, the mixing, process of mixing and recasting of 1s orbital and 1p orbitals to form two, that is TW, two different new equivalent hybrid orbitals of identical energy and shape is known as the sp hybridization. Why it is also called as a linear hybridization? Because the shape of the molecules are formed under the sp hybridization is a linear shape. Therefore, it is also called as the linear hybridization. It is also called as a diagonal hybridization. See, try to understand, it is also called as a diagonal, means the bond angle, the shape is completely linear. Therefore, it is called as the linear hybridization as well as the diagonal hybridization. The shape of a molecule is linear. Shape of molecule is linear. Bond angle is 180 degree. Okay, try to understand, the bond angle is 180 degree because the shape is very linear. Whenever there is a linear shape is there, we can measure the bond angle between the central atom and the attached atom. This must be the angle between these two central atom as well as the attached atoms, the bond angle is the 180. Example, here we can see beryllium hydrogen, that is beryllium dihydrogen, beryllium difluoride, beryllium difluoride like molecules, they can be formed in sp hybridization. Let me see the one example for this sp hybridization. Formation of BH2, that is beryllium dihydrogen molecules, very simple. A central atom is the boron. Whenever we studying about the hybridization for any hybridization, whether it is sp, sp2 or sp3, you can take any hybridization. First, we try to understand the central atom. Central atom is very important because the central atom atomic orbitals always goes under the hybridization. Okay, the atomic orbitals of central atom, they go under the hybridization and form the new hybrid orbitals. Okay, likewise, central atom is very important. Whenever when we try to understand the concept of hybridization, we must know the first of all the atomic that is electronic configuration of the central atom in the ground state as well as the electronic configuration of the central atom in the excited state. As we know that when hybridization takes place, always the central atom electrons are under the excited state. So therefore, here we can see for our convenience, here I written the beryllium. Beryllium is atomic number 4, having the 1s2, 2s2, 2p0. Here s orbital containing 2 fulfill electrons, second 2s orbital containing the fulfill electrons. But still it is having the no any unpaired electron, but it undergoes the hybridization. How it can be possible? Here we can see that is attached atom. This is a surrounded atom. Can we say as the surrounded atom? What are the central atom is the beryllium and surrounded atom is the hydrogen. Hydrogen atomic number is the one. It having the one s electron, means s electron in the 1s orbital. So here we can see the block diagrams of this beryllium atom. This is Be, 2s orbital having the paired electron. 2p is the completely vacant. This is in the ground state of the electronic configuration. Be having the two electrons in the s orbital. P orbital is empty. This is called like the beryllium atom in the ground state. But as we know that whenever hybridization takes place, the central atom must undergo the excited state. What will happen in this excited state? This unpaired electron of the paired electron, they get converted into the unpaired. Means this electron, that is beryllium of 2s electron, get excited, get promoted towards the vacant 1p orbital. See, because we need, whenever there is a formation of BeH2 is there, there must be two unpaired electrons should be required. Okay, jeva aplyala beryllium dihydrogen molecule aplyala tayar karacha asel tar form honar asel, we must require the two unpaired electrons in the central atom of the beryllium. So therefore, but we seen in the ground state it is a no any unpaired electron, but at the time of the hybridization, this central atom of the beryllium excited, means they undergoes the, at the time of the hybridization, this filled 2s orbital of this two electrons, they get converted into the unpaired, means they get promoted to the vacant 2p orbitals of 2px orbital, and this unpaired electron and this unpaired electron, that is unpaired electron in the s orbital and one unpaired electron in the p orbital, they get undergo hybridization. Here the mixing and recasting takes place of these two atomic orbital of 1s, that is 2s and the 2p orbitals, and to form two sp hybrid orbitals. Here you can see that is two different sp hybrid orbitals. As we seen in the characteristics of hybrid orbitals, here we can see this is the s orbital, this is the spherical s orbital, and this is the py or px, you can take it any orbital, that is of this one, that is p orbital, form, that is sp hybrid orbitals. We have the, whenever the shape is always try to understand in the space, if two are there, it always occupied with the a complete expansion of the linear space, linear shape in the space, therefore it forms the linear hybrid orbitals. Once the hybrid orbitals are formed, this is, you can see here in the another picture, that is sp hybrid orbitals, that is beryllium sp hybrid orbitals. Here we can see there are one larger lobe is there, one smaller lobe is there. We studied in the characteristics of hybridization, that is hybrid orbitals are concentrated in one direction, they form a large lobe and the small lobe is there. Therefore here we can see this is the large lobe having the one unpaired electron, and here it is the small lobe. Here it is one unpaired electron is there in one hybrid orbitals and one electron in the one hybrid orbitals, so they get combined, we have the two unpaired electrons now. So here BeH2 molecule is there, hydrogen atom having the one unpaired electron, hydrogen atom having the one unpaired electrons. So this unpaired electrons of hydrogen, this hydrogen unpaired electron, and they get combined with the hybrid orbitals of the beryllium and to form the this complete BeH2 molecules. Here we can see the bond angle. This is the bond angle where the here hydrogen atom is there, here hydrogen atom is there. If you calculate this bond angle, this will become the 180. So therefore, geometry of this BeH2 is the linear shape. Okay, the geometry of molecule is the linear, or shape of this molecule is the linear. Hence the bond angle between the hydrogen, beryllium and hydrogen, here hydrogen is there, okay, here it is hydrogen is there, and here it is the hydrogen is there. So therefore here hydrogen, hydrogen, and this central atom is the B, that is Be, that is beryllium. So here we can see, so what we try to understand here, hydrogen, beryllium and hydrogen, if you put a straight line, so this is the bond angle in the 180. So therefore the bond angle between the HBeH is the 180, therefore it is called as the linear hybridization, or shape of this molecule is linear, therefore it is called as the linear hybridization. So this is the things where we can see formation of beryllium dihydrogen or beryllium dichloride or beryllium trifluoride. Next we see sp2 hybridization. This is also similar to this, that of sp hybridization, but the thing is that here we have the sp2. This 2 indicates the s indicates the 1s orbital, this 2 indicates the 2p orbitals. Getting my point, in the sp hybridization there is one s orbital is there, one p orbital was there, but here in sp2 it indicates that one s orbital and the 2p orbital. Here the process of mixing and recasting of one s orbital and 2p orbitals to form three new equivalent hybrid orbitals of identical energy and shape is known as the sp2 hybridization. So try to understand here, the mixing and recasting of this sp2 indicates one s orbital p square, that is p2 indicates the 2p orbitals. So one s orbital and 2p orbital mixing and recasting is takes place and form into how many? Three new equivalent hybrid orbitals of identical energy and shape is known as the sp2 hybridization. Okay, the shape of this molecule is trigonal planar. Shape of this molecule is trigonal planar. Always we try to understand the three hybrid orbitals are there. So we have to put it in the space. What, how they can occupy? They can occupy in the trigonal planar space, planar shape. So therefore, this hybridization is also called as the trigonal hybridization. This hybridization also called as the trigonal hybridization. Due to the trigonal shape, it is also called as the trigonal hybridization. Bond angle is how much? Bond angle is 120 degree. Here we try to understand the shape. We have likewise in the planar shape, we have this shape is there. Means here as a surrounded atom, here surrounded atom, here surrounded atom, here the central atom will be there. So likewise the bond angle is the 180. If you consider this bond angle, that is the 120 degree Celsius. Molecules BF3 or BCl3, here you can see. Let me see the formation of BF3 molecules. First try to understand the whenever there is a hybridization of certain molecules we are going to discuss. First, try to understand what is the central atom and what is the surrounded atom. What is central atom? Central atom is the boron. What is surrounded atom? Surrounded atom is the fluorine. So, central atom, the boron, which is B, indicating the atomic number 5, and the surrounding atoms are the fluorine. What is atomic number 5? First, try to write the electronic configuration of boron in ground state. How it is? 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Here 2s2 is fulfilled. Here p orbital having the one electron. How many electrons? It has only one electron. But in case of for the formation of a BF3 molecule, there are three surrounded molecules are there. We require two more of the unpaired electrons for bond formation. But in the same case, the boron atom in excited state, in the ground state having the one electron. But at the time of the hybridization, the boron atom get excited and these paired electrons are converted into the get transferred toward the vacant 2p orbital, which is in the 2p orbital. So now it becomes the three unpaired electrons. Here it is one unpaired electron, here it is one unpaired electron, here it is the one unpaired electron. Means one s orbital having the one unpaired electron and two p orbitals having the two different unpaired electrons undergo hybridization. They form 3sp2 hybrid orbital. This is called as the 3sp2 hybrid. Here this is the one hybrid, this is the one hybrid orbital, this is the one hybrid orbital. Here we can see this is one s orbital, 2p, that is one px orbital, one py orbital, and they form the sp2 hybrid trigonal planar hybrid orbitals. Now this trigonal sp2 hybrid orbital, that is trigonal planar hybrid orbital, they get combined with the now fluorine. We have the fluorine is one unpaired electron. In this case here you can see the fluorine having the atomic number 9, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. Means what? 2s is completely fulfilled. 2p5 means initially they have the one single electron, and then we go for the paired electrons. Here it is having the only one unpaired electron for the bond formation. But one fluorine having the one unpaired electrons. We have the three different unpaired electrons in hybrid orbitals. Therefore, we required three fluorine atoms get combined. Likewise, see, okay, this is the pz orbitals of one fluorine. Here 3 indicates that three fluorine atoms of the pz orbitals, they get combined with sp2 hybrid orbitals of a beryllium to form the all the sigma bonds. Likewise, there is a shape of trigonal planar. This is the BF3 molecule, this is central molecule boron, and this is the fluorine. This is the fluorine, and this is the fluorine. So therefore, the geometry of a molecule is trigonal planar, and the bond angle between this one, this is the 120. Here you can say this is of 120 degree of the bond angle. This is the bond angle is 120. This is the bond angle is the 120. Now here it is a boron atom centrally, and it is a fluorine atom, and here it is a fluorine atom. Okay, and here also the fluorine atom is there. Therefore, the formation of BF3 molecule is a sp2 hybridization having the bond angle in between, that is FBF, that is fluorine, boron and fluorine, is the 120 degree. Okay. Now let we have sp3 hybridization. This is also called as the tetrahedral hybridization. Very simple. When we understand the concept of sp and sp2, here this indicates the sp3 hybridization. What is 3 indicates? s is the 1s orbital, and what is the p3 indicates? p3 indicates that 3p orbital. Okay, now in case of sp3 hybridization, the process of mixing and recasting of 1s orbital and 3p orbitals, 1s orbital and 3p orbitals, to form 4 new equivalent hybrid orbitals of identical energy and identical shape, known as the sp3 hybridization. Okay, the shape of molecule is tetrahedral, therefore it is called as the tetrahedral hybridization. It is also called as the tetrahedral hybridization. The bond angle is 109.28 degrees. See, this is the 109.28. The example here we can see formation of methane, formation of nickel tetracarbonyl, which is example of sp3 hybridization. Here very simple, try to understand the formation of CH4 molecules. As I told that whenever a molecule going to explain the hybridization, first try to understand the central atom. Your central atom is the carbon, surrounding atom is the hydrogen. Always the central atom undergo the excited station or excited state or for the hybridization. Carbon atom having the atomic number 6, it having the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2 in their ground state. Means here it having the 2 fulfill electron in the s orbital, 1 unpaired electron in the p orbital, 1 unpaired electron in the p orbital. But it having only 2 unpaired electrons. But for the formation of CH4, surrounding molecules are 4 are there. But you required 2 more of electron unpaired for the bond formation of CH4. So therefore, okay, this is the carbon ground state electronic configuration. Here it is carbon in the excited state electronic configuration. What will happen in the excited state? This fulfilled 2s orbitals, one electron is get converted to the this of vacant p orbitals. Likewise here we can see. Now in carbon atom in the excited state having the 4 unpaired electrons, that is 1s orbital and 3p orbitals, they go under hybridization to form sp3 4 hybrid orbitals, like in a shape is tetrahedral. Here we can see the shape, s orbital, px orbital, py orbital, pz orbital, and they get formed sp3 hybrid orbitals having the tetrahedral shape is there. Now this formed sp3 hybrid orbitals, here we can see what is the formation is the CH4. Central atom is always it's formed the 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. What are the surrounding atoms? Surrounding atom is the hydrogen atom. It having the 1 unpaired electrons, but it requires 1 unpaired electrons in 1 hydrogen atom. But there is the formation of CH4 is there. Means you require 4 hydrogen atoms for combining sp3 hybrid orbitals of tetrahedral shape, which having the carbon atom, form into CH4 molecule. That is CH4. Here C is there, here H is there, here H is there, here H is there, here H is there. These unpaired electrons are formed with the, they get formed and forming a covalent bond with a sigma bond. It forms into tetrahedral shape. Therefore, the geometry of a molecule is tetrahedral and the bond angle is the HCH is in 109, that is 109.28 degrees of the bond angle is there in the plane. Therefore, it is a tetrahedral shape is there. It is called as the tetrahedral hybridization. Okay, I hope. So with this, I will stop here. We understand now sp hybridization, sp2 hybridization and sp3 hybridization in this lecture. With this, I will stop here. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon button for latest videos upgrade. Thank you for watching.